Good morning, children. Today my subject is science, and I'll go with the topic of science in everyday life. Science in everyday life. What do you mean by that? We'll start our daily life with the basic needs of food, clothes, shelter, transport, communication, everything. So, without this, we can't live. So in the olden days, the early woman is living like they don't know how to live or to eat and what to wear and where to get the shelter. So they started their life with the confusion. They'll go by if they get hungry, what they are doing, if they see any fruits, they eat that. And if they see any animals, they kill that animals with the wooden knife and eating that flesh of the animals. So if they get the cold or hot, they used to wear a leaf of the tree. They'll cover their body with the leaves. And for the shelter, they're going to sleep under the tree shades or in the caves. So day by day, they also improved with the sowing the seeds and agricultural, and they started coming day by day. They also invented the wheels in the wood. So all this day by day they improved. Now science technology has been improved. So I'll go by this. First I'll give you introduction of this. Your class is going on a tour to a museum arranged by your school. So, your class is going on a tour to the museum arranged by your school. Let me ask you some questions in this regard. You are instructed to be neatly dressed in school uniform. They have been instructed you. Even as well as in your schools also, the school management and school teachers are instructed to come neatly to the school with a well manner. How will you ensure that your dress is neat? How you will going to ensure that your dress is neat? Question, huh? You are instructed to get your lunch box from home. So, at the school, they instructed you should get your lunch box from the home. How does your mother cook lunch, and where do the food ingredients come from? From where all this come from? Question mark. How your class travel to the museum? Question mark. A little after you reach the museum, your friend complained of stomachache. What will you do, or whom will you take him to? And how will you inform his parents in needed? All these questions asked for you. So, let's come up with the answers now. All this your diary needs, diary what you will do, going to do if it is happens in the schools. So, you will use a detergent and wash your uniform either by hand or by using a washing machine. So for this is the answer for first question. How will you ensure that your dress is neat? How you are going to ensure, how you are going to prove that your dress is neat? So that you are going to use the detergent and wash your uniform neatly, either by hand or using a machine. You will dry it in the sun and then press it using an electric iron. There also you have used an electric iron box to iron your dress and come neatly to the school. This is how you are ensured your uniform is very neat. And your mother cooks lunch on a gas or an electric stove. Here they asked, how does your mother cook lunch and where do the food ingredients come from? Where do the food ingredients come from? You all know that You all know that your mother cooks lunch on a gas or electric stove, is it not? And in everyone's house, there will be electric stove. You then pack your lunch box, the food ingredients that have been used to prepare your lunch. So, the food ingredients, your mother will go to the market, supermarket, and she'll get some vegetables, some fruits, everything for you to prepare lunch for you. To the box, like rice, pulses, and vegetables came from supermarket, which in turn buy them from the farmer who cultivate them. So how do you get, from where do you get that vegetables, pulses, everything? From the cultivations of the farmers. Farmers will cultivate and then they going to give it for the some shops or the supermarket. So from there we are going to buy that vegetables, fruits, everything, and we are going to prepare an delicious food for ourselves or our kids. You will travel to the museum in a bus arranged by the school. So here the question: How will your class travel to the museum? You will travel to the museum in the bus arranged by the school. So how come the school management will going to arrange the bus for you to travel from school to museum? What and all you can see in the museum? In the museum means what? I'll tell you in the next. You will inform your teacher about your friend's ill health, who will check if some first aid will help. If the problem persists, he or she will arrange for him to be taken to the doctor. So here the question: what will you do or whom will you take him to? How will you inform his parents if needed? So if your friend is she or he is complaining of stomach pain, she is not feeling well, or he or she is not feeling well, what you are going to do on at present? So you will inform your teacher, class teacher, about her illness, or you will do first aid, take her to do the first aid. If the problem persists, he or she will hurry for him to take to the doctor. The contact number of your friend's parents will be available with your teacher. In the school, your phone numbers, everything is with teachers and management, so that they are going to call in the phone. He or she will call them using his mobile phone or public land televisions. So all this are done. This is a daily life we are going to spend. So very simple questions, right? So electric, iron, gas stove, supermarket, agricultural, bus, doctor, mobile and land television, all these are electric items we are going to use in our daily life. Things that are very well known to you. Did you ever wonder how these things that we use in our everyday life are made, or who made them first, and what knowledge goes is making them? So in our everyday life, mobile is very important, is it not? You all people will do your onlines in the mobile, will watch some information from the mobiles, you will play in the mobiles. So mobile is electric items, is in all over. Without mobile, no one can stay. That is also electric, and also stove is also electric item, and some bus will ride with that, and supermarket, and mobiles, land televisions, everything. So do you know who invented all this? Who gave idea to do all this? Making them. I am sure your answer is S. In fact, it is this inquisitive, nature of man, which is responsible for the world of discoveries and invention. Inquisitive. Inquisitive means it's a curious. What is that? How to prepare now and what to invite if we are walking by like what we are going to think. Oh, we had to in some days the scientists going to think that. So we had to do something to avoid walking, so that they invited cycle, scooter, car, bus, like this. Some discoveries and invention as still now the scientists are still there's very much interested to invite some different types of vehicles. So of acquiring knowledge through questioning, observation and experimentation is known as the science. Science is nothing but an experimentation and observation. This is called as science. The word science comes from the Latin scientia, meaning knowledge. What do you mean by scientia? It means as knowledge in the Latin word. And describe any systematic field of study, purely in order to produce practical models. So this is about the science and what or not we need in our daily life and how we will be without that. It's all about, this is the first introduction about science in everyday life. I'll get back to you in the next class, children.